The Dehesa is rich in opportunities to establish a wide range of species of flora and fauna. It covers a whole mosaic of different environments, including Mediterranean woodland and areas of individual trees surrounded by grazing land, as well as shrubland, arable land, small channels, streams and pools of water, all of which support the coexistence of different species of plants and offer shelter and food to a wide range of wildlife. Making the economic sustainability of this state compatible with their natural value is one of the objectives of the LIFE-Biodehesa project. For this reason, a far-reaching, open-to-the-public Dehesas network has been established all over the Andalusian territory. The estates that comprise this network have become centers where the visitor can find specific actions being undertaken for improving and preserving biodiversity, and where the demands and concerns of those agents involved in the Dehesa sector are shared. Many aspects have been broached in this regard, so we are going to run through them briefly. As such, the woodlands play a leading role in the Dehesa, not just for their function as a producer of acorns, cork, trimming remains, fodder and firewood, but also for their ecological role in the recycling of nutrients, in the protection of the soil and the absorbing of temperatures. However, the current situation of the woodlands in the Dehesa areas is worrying. All too often, the regeneration of trees is scarce, and its viability is in jeopardy because of the herbivorous. To alleviate this, natural regeneration of the woodland has been fostered by limiting grazing, which can provide the establishment of new individual trees. The growth of the strongest existing plant shoots has also been helped by thinning or by installing individual protectors that facilitate the appearance of a new tree. On other occasions, regeneration has been carried out with artificial means by sowing seeds or placing different sized plants cultivated previously in pots. The latter option allows for the incorporation of species different from the existing ones on the estate, thus diversifying the exploitation and increasing the ecosystem's resistance to climate change or incidental pests and diseases. Regeneration presented in this way also involves a series of tasks that improve the plant's survival in the country, such as the placing of protectors against the livestock and wildlife, the application of mulch to minimize the aggressiveness of the closest herbaceous, and carrying out irrigation in the summer. The care of the existing woodlands on the estates is also essential, especially when we are dealing with those of more advanced years or those damaged or affected by pests, diseases, or other non-specific processes. In this sense, the LIFE-Biodehesa project promotes integrated monitoring actions based on the prevention of damage, the fostering of associated wildlife, and the rational use of chemical products. Those actions carried out have attempted to reduce the incidence of damage that contributes to the weakening of the woodlands. The trimming carried out has been of low intensity and respectful of the tree's structure, being done in authorized periods to that end. The tasks associated with improvements in pastures and the monitoring of shrubland have been carried out in a non-aggressive way by reducing the risk of losing fertile soil and respecting a reasonable distance from the trunk to avoid damaging the tree's roots. Pest control has been based on maintaining the balance between the populations of insects by promoting the presence of auxiliary wildlife. Nesting boxes have been installed to facilitate the nesting of bats and insectivorous birds such as the blue and the great tit, which are great consumers of insects. Vegetation diversification actions and improvements in stone walls and water points have been done together, which will allow an increase in the presence of reptiles, amphibians and small mammals. These are also implicated in a healthy ecosystem. Additionally, attention has been paid to the phenomenon commonly known as la seca, the dry one. Among the different agents behind this expression, the LIFE-Biodehesa project has focused its efforts on controlling the spreading of the so-called root rot disease, due to the gravity of the situation and expansion in the dehesas of Andalusia. The main organism that causes this disease, Phytophthora cinnamomi, is found in the soils and roots of the affected trees, and whose eradication is very complex. Preventive measures are the most effective for controlling it. Restricting the movement of soil achieves limitations on the transfer of the disease from one area to another. The installation and maintenance of dip vats at the access points to the affected areas allows the disinfestation of some of the most common spreading elements, such as vehicle and machinery wheels or livestock hooves. Another control measure has consisted in carrying out calcium phosphoric fertilizations of the soil through the use of calcium carbonate. It has been demonstrated that its utilization in affected and adjacent areas reduces the pathogen's infection capacity, as well as providing the woodland with a greater tolerance regarding the disease. Another essential element in the dehesa is the herbaceous pastures. They contain a great biodiversity of species, in many cases superior to other systems less impacted by man, and are the main food source for domestic and wild animals. Grazing plays a decisive role in the dynamics of the pastures. By being undertaken in a frequent and moderately intensive way, it can consolidate stable and quality pastures. But if the use is abandoned or through being used in excess, deterioration will take place. To count on an infrastructure network that allows for distribution of herds in the different areas of the estates is essential. To this end, feeding and drinking troughs or mobile electric fences have been installed, which optimize the managing and rotation of the livestock around the different plots of land. Improvements in the pastures have also been carried out, such as with phosphoric fertilizations and sowing with meadow species. These achieve an increase in the food available and the presence of leguminous plants such as clover, alfalfa or bird's foot, which are outstanding species due to their being well adapted to pasturing, as they are a foodstuff rich in proteins and improve the soil through nitrogen fixation. These improvements, along with the appropriate grazing management, facilitate the establishing and development of more diverse, more productive and higher quality communities. Both the existence of grazing and that of trees and shrubs have another important mission in the dehesa, which is to protect the soil against erosion. Therefore, on those occasions when the promotion of pasturing implies clearing shrubs in moderately sloping areas, they have been implemented by following the level curves and by leaving intermediate strips of vegetation. In the streams and stream beds, where it is more common to find problems of gullies formation and the resultant acceleration of soil loss, new plants have been introduced and containment systems installed, which allow soil fixation in a permeable way, thus avoiding loss of water quality through turbidity. Other actions destined to increase the presence of vegetation and to improve biodiversity have attempted to introduce new species and obtain greater complexity in their distribution over the terrain. The main woodland has been improved by plantations of new holms, cork trees, Portuguese oaks and carob trees. In those watercourses prone to flooding, riverside vegetation and trees have been encouraged. Ash, poplars, alder and oleander trees and rushes, among others. In certain enclaves or border areas between managed plots, different shrub land species, such as the mastic tree, the strawberry tree, wild olive and olivillo, have been introduced, some of which have a certain fodder importance, and others, such as rosemary and thyme, or lavender, whose bee or aromatic suitability favors the presence of bees. Regarding wildlife, the actions carried out have been addressed to encouraging certain species considered crucial for developing biodiversity. In this sense, apart from the specific nests for promoting the presence of insectivorous birds and bats, the presence of rabbits has also been encouraged due to their role as an essential link as a foodstuff for numerous species of birds of prey, mammals, and reptiles. To that end, sheltered areas, tubular or pallet cairns, have been installed, which, in some cases, have been complemented by the release of rabbits. And finally, the renovation and adaptation of certain traditional elements, such as stone walls and drinking troughs, means that the dehesas continue to be witness to lichens, mosses, ferns, and other plants, as well as an innumerable number of insects, reptiles, amphibians, and small mammals that find there food and shelter. The preservation of these elements, so bound to the identity of the Dehesa peoples, is a commitment to the landscape and the legacy bestowed by the life and customs of those people who used to live there and still do so today. Sharing the dehesa with the flora and fauna that forms part of it is a simple task. Let's just allow it to continue being what it is, a diverse area, rich and complex, which we can keep living off, while at the same time being generous to its biodiversity.